My name is Chengal Reddy. I am the Chief Advisor, Consortium of Indian Farmers Associations. We farmers have been facing many problems. We want to highlight the problems and also suggest solutions so that they can be solved in a time-bound manner. We have now commenced a program called We Farmers. This is a YouTube TV program. The first program we are commencing is about paying of compensation to farmers whose lands become valueless under electric high tension towers. The Government of India in 2003 has made Electricity Act 2003 and also in 2006 made rules. According to rules, if the transmission company has to construct a tower and draw a line in farmer's land, they have to seek farmer's consent. This is under Rule 31A. If the farmer refuses consent, the transmission company can approach the district collector and the collector is empowered to fix the compensation. After settlement of the compensation, the transmission companies can construct the towers and draw the lines. What happens when towers are constructed and lines are drawn? The existing crops, including gardens, plantation crops, if there is a tube well, if there is a shed, they are all destroyed because each tower weighs almost 20 tons. You have to draw steel, cement and concrete for constructing those huge towers. And likewise, when you're drawing lines across from one tower to other towers, the land underneath also will be, the crops will be damaged. After constructing towers, under each tower almost 1,000 square yards will become permanently valueless. In fact, not only that anything can be grown, that whole 1,000 square yards will become, it cannot be used for anything else. It becomes, even though the land remains in the name of the farmer, it can't be used for any purpose. Between the, under the lines, like for every 1 kilometer, almost 10 to 12 acres will lose total value. Under the lines, there is a electromagnetic field, humming sound, and also during rains and other thunderstorms, there is every possibility of electric shocks. So there is prohibition for constructing any house, building, godown or shed. The farmer, very surprisingly, the land remains in the name of the farmer. It is just a piece of paper. He can't use it, he can't mortgage it to get loan. Or if there is a marriage for his children, he can't sell it. Or if there is a health problem, he can't sell it. He can't pass it on to the children. So the futuristic value of the land is permanently lost. What has happened in 2003 when this made this Electricity Act, they also framed the rules. Interestingly, under Section 3.5, they have put a clause saying that none of these rules are applicable under 164 of Electricity Act. This Electricity Act 164 empowers the transmission companies with the telegraph powers. Now, what is a telegraph pole and tower? We know hardly it is a 10 feet across and weighs about 150 kg. And in the 19th century, when telegraph poles are introduced, they were mostly on the railway lines. And there was virtually no land damage, nor there is a crop damage. But in 2003, when these towers are constructed, when the act is passed, the act made a provision in regard to the farmers to apply the rule of 1885 Telegraph Act. Now, how can a telegraph pole, which is just about 10 feet width and 100 feet weight, be compared with a high-tension electric transmission towers of 400 kV or 765 kV, which weighs 20 tons, solid tons, and occupies huge land and makes the entire land underneath virtually useless? Now, the We have made a representation to the Prime Minister. The details are available on our website www.indianfarmers.org. What we have requested the Prime Minister is, sir, the land underneath becomes virtually valueless. So the farmer must be compensated. And the compensation is not only for the loss of crops, but also loss of the value. Sir, today land is considered as a human right. And even though here, very interestingly, the land remains in the name of the farmer, it is virtually an illusionary title deed. It has no futuristic value. And you cannot deprive a farmer of its land, which is now considered as a human right. So this is the issue which we are placing before all of you. The details are available in our website. My request to all of you, the farmers, and those others interested in the farmers' welfare, please write a letter to the Prime Minister requesting that he must make amendments to this act and also pay the compensation to the farmers. In the last 20 years, 40 lakh farmers are deprived of their compensation. The transmission company is a profit-making company. In 2014-15, they have made a profit of 4,650 crores and declared a dividend of 660 crores. All that they need to pay to the farmer is just about 1,000 crores. Instead, they deliberately misused these provisions of the Electricity Act and deprived the farmer of their legally entitled compensation. My appeal to all of you is kindly help in getting these farmers the compensation. I'll be really grateful. Thank you.